Hi everybody, it's Lord Magicus. Alright, we're back to playing Mono Blue Devotion and Pioneer. So, we just came off a very awesome Modern League where the list actually got published for that one. That was awesome. And our last Pioneer League, we also went 5-0 with that. So, we're doing super, super well lately. So, let's hope that we can keep it going. Alright. So I had a few different lists I was actually looking at for today, but the one that I ended up deciding on, I wanted to play the most number of new cards from Theros, because everybody likes new cards, and everybody wants to see new stuff in action. So you know what, I figured, let's just start with that. Alright, so what's the most spicy stuff we got? First of all, Shadow Spear. I think one of the things that we have trouble with is sometimes being able to race some of the aggro decks, and honestly, I think Shadow Spear is a good answer to that. Plus one, trample, and lifelink. It costs one, and it's two to equip, so it's pretty cheap. We can play it on turn one pretty easily. Well, it helps fix our curve a little bit, so we have more one drops, so we're not doing nothing on turn one most of the time. Yeah, and you know we can, and then later on we can just equip it. Like we can play Storm Tamer, and if we have nothing to do on turn two, maybe just equip it, attack for two lifelink. That's always good. Or just later on, maybe like turn four, just you know equip it to like you know some creature and attack, and then still have two mana up to do something else, like maybe Singer or Trickster or Borrower or maybe even Retort. So I think this is good. This other ability, I doubt this is going to be relevant. There's not too many hexproof or indestructible things we need to worry about. I mean, I'm trying to think, like, this could theoretically be relevant for, not for our deck, but maybe like another deck, like Blue-White Control maybe would want something to sideboard this. And the reason they might want to is because they can use it to Field a Ruin, like, the hell is it, the Lotus Land, yeah, the one, yeah, damn it, why can I not think of the name of it, Lotus Field, that's the one, because they can just make it lose Hexproof and then Field it, ruin it, or, you know, one interaction that we might care about is, we can make a Darksteel Citadel lose Indestructible, so if it gets, like, in Soul Artifact, maybe like Thassa can block it, and we can remove its indestructible and kill it that way. So I don't think this ability is going to be super relevant, but it's not like it's a terrible thing to have. I'm fine with just using, you know, this first ability on this. Because I don't know if you noticed, we got some chonk to our deck, and any of our three drops, if they hit somebody with that, that's like an 8-point life swing, because we're going to hit for at least 4 damage, maybe way more than that, maybe 5 or 6, and we're going to gain that much back in life, so that's going to help swing races a lot. And a lot of our creatures have evasion, so it's going to be, it should be pretty easy to keep poking in with this thing and gaining life with it. So I decided that I wanted to try out the Threnody Singer. Its devotion ability is it gives a creature minus X minus 0, and it's a 1/3 flash flying creature. And I chose to cut Harbinger for this, and I think that it makes sense because this way it gives us the maximum number of things that we can do for 2 mana at flash speed. Because now we have access to Singer, Merfolk Trickster, Brazen Borrower, and occasionally Wizard's Retort, assuming we have a wizard in play. So our passing with 2 mana up actually represents a lot more stuff now that we can threaten this to come into play. It also makes our opponent a lot more likely to make bad attacks, because they might think, okay, well, I'm attacking with a big scare, maybe like a Goblin Chain Whirler, and if we can give it -3/-0, we can just gang block it with a bunch of stuff and then actually be able to kill it, which will be very nice. Being a 1/3 is also very relevant. In a different version of this deck that we might try out eventually, the 1/3 I think actually plays really well with Cloudfin Raptor because it means it can evolve it twice. So having the Cloudfin's a 0/1, so having 3 toughness means you can play 2 of these and each one will evolve it. So it helps it same way. It has the same level of like evolve that like Trickster does. So I like it. Yeah, it has some strength, and we'll probably see it in some other lists that we're going to test out, but 1-3 also means that it dodges Wild Slash. So if we go to equip it with a Shadow Spear and may try to make it a 2-4, they can't just slash it in response. The same way that if we did it to Harbingers, Harbinger would just die and we would have wasted 2 mana. So for that reason, I'm willing to try this in this version of this deck along with the Spear. And having Flying means that it can probably connect with this a little bit better too. Also worth noting, if you equip the Spear to it, it can block and kill a Phoenix in combat. Yeah, 2-4 will beat the 3-2 Phoenix every time. So that's worth noting. Trickster stays, Thassa stays. I cut the Cyclonic Rifts from this version because we're only going to play 2 Nykthos and 21 Islands. We're not as heavy on the early devotion stuff, I think. We're playing a little bit more of like a mid-rangey plan. So I think because we're not looking to go super over the top with stuff like Cyclonic Rift and or like Spectral Sailor, for instance, that was another card in a different version I was looking to test with Nykthos. I think just 2 Nykthos will be fine, just for Gadwick in the late game. So instead we cut 2 Cyclonic Rifts, and then we added 1 extra Brazen Borrower to help try to keep our curve a little bit balanced. So now we still have like 11 things to do on turn 2. Sometimes Wizard Retort, but I'm not going to count that consistently because you have to lead off the Storm Tamer for that. So, yeah, I wanted to make sure we didn't run out of bounce spells. So, you know, I think 3 Borrower is fine. This card is great. You could easily, like, argue running 4 of this, but I needed to make some cut somewhere so we could try some of our new stuff. And so the other new card we're going to try is Caliph, Beloved of the Sea. Now, we're talking about Chonky. Look at this guy. Power is equal to your devotion to blue, and he also has some soft protection for your permanent. So anything that they want to hit you with, they want to Wild Slash your stuff, it's going to cost them an extra 1 to do it. So now you have 2 mana removal spell for Trickster, or if they have stuff like Lightning Strike, they have to pay 3 mana for it. That's nice. And again, 3 toughness means he dodges Slash, which is very good. And yeah, his power is just going to get absurd. Like, this thing could easily be like 8 power, and we're going to give it Shadow Spear so it gets lifelink and trample. So we're not afraid to throw it into combat to suicide and die if it's going to get in like 6 damage and gain us like 8 life. So yeah, that's totally worth it, I think. It's almost as good of a threat as Tempestion is, where just over the course of the game, as our board develops, it's just going to get stronger and stronger the same way Jhin does. It doesn't have the flying evasion that Jhin does, and its butt is not quite as big. Jhin dodges stuff like Lightning Strike on top of this, but I think Caliph is worth testing. And because it's legendary, though, I'm only going to play 2. I want to play 2 so we can, like, you know, actually get to see it in action, but I don't want to play more than that just because we don't want to see more than one of these in a game. Or at least not at one time, anyway. Yeah, we want to be able to stick as many of our threats as possible. Gadwick is the exception because he still does stuff when you play the copies 2 through 4 of him. So that's what our main deck looks like. Sideboard, still have 2 Damping Spears. This card is going to be very relevant against the Underworld Breach decks. Their goal is to try to net mana by casting like a bajillion spells in one, or not net mana. They need to like go mana neutral in order to win the game, basically. So if you can tax them on every subsequent spell, they will not be able to go through their whole deck and win. The rest of these cards are basically the same. Spyglass, we still want this against Planeswalkers. Drake and our Tidebinder Mage. Yeah, we want them for like the red decks. Tidebinder helps against like mono green. Mystical Dispute, again, another control card. And we're gonna try one other new card. This is Ashiok's Erasure. And some people have expressed concern that I don't know if the mono blue deck can beat control. Well, first of all, I think that the deck can definitely beat control, but since everybody's worried about Verdict and they're like, how are you going to beat that? Well, here's how we're going to do it. We're going to flash in Ashiok's erasure, and we are going to exile the Verdict. And as long as Verdict is exiled underneath this thing, they don't get to cast anymore. So they have to find a way to deal with this. But normally, if it was like Spellqueller, I might not consider playing it. But so the neat thing about this is, even if they remove the Ashiok's erasure later on, they get the Verdict back to hand. If they get the Verdict back, they don't get to cast it immediately like they would if it was like Spellqueller. They actually have to like spend mana and cast it again. So if they try to like wait until, you know, to fight over this card, so if you exile it and then later on they like play a Teferi in like next turn and bounce it, they're not gonna necessarily have the mana to cast the Verdict in the same turn they get rid of this thing. And they don't have a whole lot of ways of getting rid of it. I think it's mostly just gonna be like their Teferis. So, again, you can kind of create, like, a little lock if you, like, Spyglass the Teferi and then, you know, hit the Verdicts with this. Like, you can definitely do some real damage to their deck like that. So, I think this is fine. And it also will count for Devotion, too. And, you know, being an enchantment that has Flash means that Nykthos gets to make more mana when we do this, which means our Gadwex will be even that more strong. So, I think, yeah, this looks like this has a bunch of really interesting, fun cards in it. Let's go and try this and see how well this does compared to our more stock list from last time. Ugh. So, Pioneer, let's go for this. Mono Blue Devotion, excellent. League. And play points. All right, let's do this. So yeah, this is the mono blue chunk version of this deck, and there I will have probably at least two more builds of this that we can try out in our next couple leagues, depending upon how this goes. I mean, if this really impresses me, we might just stick with this, but I have at least two more lists. I want to try one with Spectral Sailor and try one with Cloudfin Raptor. Because I think that there's merit to both of them. They can go... You can either go, like the Cloudfin one is the more aggro version. This is, like, the more mid-range version. And then the Sailor one with the extra Nykthos, I think, is the more over-the-top devotion. Like, that's, like, the big version of the deck. Because that one, you're looking to do stuff like Nykthos to cast overloaded Cyclonic Rifts and stuff, or just use Sailor to draw like two cards every turn. So I think, yeah, start out in the medium one and see how we like it from there. Alright. Been looking forward to this a lot. So we are on the play. This is absolutely fine. Get Trickster online and then followed up with Caliph. Get our Chonk going. Chonk is such a great word. I love it. That's amazing. Oh, we're going to get Thoughts. No? Okay, so we're up against Elves. Okay. So we are almost certainly... Well, the good news is that we actually have Caliph, and they might be looking to go, like, turn two, what's-his-face here. Okay, well, I think we're going to just Trickster this down in the upkeep, because I don't want them to, Steel Leaf, yeah, I don't want them to do that in turn two. So yeah, so we'll tap this down to the upkeep, give ourselves some time to get some chalk on the board. Again, such a great word. I can't stop that. That's just a new part of my vocabulary permanently now. What the hell is this? Wait, is this like the Dredgeless deck or what's going on? Okay, well that can't block, so that's fine with me. So you know what? We could either play Calif here, or we could play Gadwick. Think we should just probably play Gadwick first. So give us more devotion, but also now we'll be able to start tapping down their stuff. So Singer will get even stronger. I'm not gonna block this stupid thing, no. Okay, so this thing can't attack or block it. Oh, that's beautiful. So we can just attack him for five. Like, I think we're in a really commanding position right now. Can't attack or block. So what is. Are they playing like Heliod in this deck? Is that what's going. Is that why they have this? Because they just need like artifacts? I'm trying to think. I think there is like an Abzan version playing that, but I don't know. This is hard to say. I don't know what that like is going on with this deck. So I don't think that I'm really concerned by that right now. I'm just trying to figure out do I mean, I guess I can just play Storm Tamer here. I can just tap this thing. And then we can just flash in one of these things in their turn. All right. I'm gonna wait until they go to combat to do this. Yeah, okay. That's not really a problem for us. Chadwick is still totally fine here. He has a power four or creature of power four or greater, so. Options are I could give it minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Actually, I think here we just want to cast Merfolk Trickster. Let's target the Regisaur. We'll target Renoas or whatever. Yeah, that's fine. I think it attack us for three is not going to do anything. Oh, okay. You know what? That's fine. If you want to hit us for seven, I'm not really concerned about that. We're attacking for way more. Do I care about this? No, not really. So let's see. We can attack back for seven. I mean, we're still threatening to tap down two things, and we still have a blocker, so I guess I'm not really worried about this. I'll just take the 10. Right. So, yeah, I'm just going to probably use Singer to tap down this. And then give this, like, minus 7 or something. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, yeah. Does it matter here? If they attack with the Scrounger and try to pump it up. They don't have enough mana to do this twice. But I will leave the Storm Tamer back just in case, I think. So I can tap. I don't know. I guess I want to just be a little bit safe here. Okay. Ooh, interesting. So we actually have a choice here. He's gonna trade with Gedwick, so yeah, I don't want this. I can't have that getting trample. It's gonna take away from our devotion a lot too. Ugh, I don't like this. Okay, so we have op like it could just trade with this thing, or we can just play the singer, but then we're not going to be able to. Okay, so we actually are kind of in trouble right now. Well, they can only do this once. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We can give this minus 6. I guess I have to just let this trade happen. Yeah, and this is why we left the Storm Tamer back. They had two Blossoming Defenses. Ugh, that's brutal. Yeah. You know what? That was probably not a good idea. I should have did this first so that I forced him to pump something up. Oh, yeah, that was definitely a mistake. I needed to do this before he attacked because I forgot this wouldn't. He'd have to, like, actually pump something up before he attacks, and then we would know where we need to block. Okay. That didn't actually do anything, though. So 5. So we can block here and block here. Yeah, alright, that's not good. We don't really have a good way of actually ending this game. It's only 3. We can play Caliph, but this thing's indestructible. I think we're actually just dead here. Yeah, alright, we lose, because they can just give one of these things trample, and there's no way that we can actually like block enough of this to matter. Because literally, all of these things are already killing us. Yeah, alright, well. He had two Blossoming Defenses. That was just too much. Now, like, we did get stuck on 3 lands, too. I think if we could have got another land, maybe we would have had more options. Well, that's unfortunate. But the good news is that we have Tidebinder Mages, which should help a little bit against this deck. I think Shadow Spear is going to be very good, too. Let's see here. I don't know, like, maybe Retort is fine. Honestly, all of these cards look like they're pretty good. What about you? They have actually very big blockers. Yeah, I don't know. Like, the Storm Tamers also are not terribly strong. I guess the Retorts are a little bit better if we're keeping in Tidebinder Mages. Alright, what if I cut this? And like, I think all the Tempo Bears are actually fine. Tempishin is also fine. Borrower's fine. Like, we definitely have the tools for this. I guess maybe I'll cut one Wizard's Retort. That was too much. I was really maybe that attack was greedy. Maybe I should just not have attacked with Gedwick. I didn't even think about this possibility of that, because we really needed to tap down two creatures, or we needed to take two creatures out of combat in that turn. And them being able to trade the elf with Gedwick was a huge blowout. So I'm not familiar with this list at all, so this is like entirely new to me, so my inexperience in this match might cause us to lose, so that's possible. I do want to play first. I guess this is okay. We can actually curve into Master of Waves. We'll get a bajillion tokens. They didn't actually play like a single removal spell. I assume they have stuff or something, but I haven't seen anything, so yeah, Llanowar. Oh, that's beautiful. Tidebinder this down. Yep. Okay, you have another Mystic. Oh, that's beautiful. So basically, whatever they play this turn, we can just bounce it back to their hand. Or we could just flash in Borrower. Go for big Master of Waves. It was also a fine turn to play Gadwick, I guess. Okay. Fuck it, we'll bounce that back. Right, let's play Gadwick and draw a card. Because this will set up for Master of Waves to be huge. Great. That actually is great. I don't mean to be sarcastic about that. Questing Beast, that's a little bit rough, but you know what? We can suck it up. We'll be able to tap it down. So I think what I might want to do next is actually I can play Borrower and tap this thing down. And then next turn, just play this and tap it down again. And then next turn, we can play Master of Waves and have up Wizard's Retort. Yeah, I think I don't want that. I will counter that, and I'm going to tap down the Questing Beast. So they can make it much bigger, and there's no reason for us to allow that. They wanted to get greedy so they can give it, the bonus and give it trample. All right, I mean, yeah, it's fine. You're also very close to death. Yep. That's also very strong. So let's see. Can just play Master of Waves now. Tap this thing down. Right, upkeep, and again, we'll just tap down more of his creatures. And that should do the trick. How do you come back from that? I don't think you can. Okay. So that was. We drew that one up a lot more like how it was supposed to go. Yeah, I think that worked out fine. The retort's probably not quite as good on the draw. Yeah, I think this was still okay. I'm just gonna keep it as is. They still haven't played any actual removal spells. They've just played, given their guys hexproof. Unfortunately, this is not keepable because we need at least two land. If we had a second land, I would keep this, but this is better. Keep, and I guess I'm going to put a Storm Tamer in the bottom. We will have Wizard to Tord up on turn two, though. Okay, so that's good. They're not going to get Rhinoceros underneath us this time. And we are going to curve into Tempest Gin, which is nice. Okay. I think here I just attack. Could play Lovestruck Beast. If he plays Lovestruck Beast, I don't really care though. It's not something I want to bounce back to his hand though. So I guess here I'm just gonna pass, and if he doesn't do anything, like, I don't know, I might use Brazen Borrower. Depends, but plays like a yeah, I think that's worth countering. So that takes like his old turn. Oh, he's got a Shadow Spear too. All right, scary. Right, well, I think. This is probably a good turn to get Jhin online. He's tapped out, so it doesn't matter if we do this first. But this way, then if we draw like either Spear, or if we draw a land, we can like play Master of Waves, or maybe Borrower plus Tideminder. That would be good, actually. I'm expecting his turn might just be play Lovestruck, or well, he could equip this, but he doesn't have anything good to put it on yet. Okay, that's definitely going to get bounced. Okay, well, so I have to hold up Brazen Borrower here, because he's definitely going to equip Shadow Spear to this thing. I'll make him discard first. Yeah, okay. Let him go to attacks. Hope that he does not have the blossoming defense. Oh, he does. Fuck. Damn it! Well, this is gonna hurt. We actually are taking a bajillion damage now. Well, fuck. He only had two cards in hand, and that was one of the two that was left. Unfortunately, because this has trample now, I don't think there's any way we can actually beat this. Yeah, we lose because they had Blossoming Defense and we didn't have anything for it. That's fine. Nope. All right. Well, maybe we just needed to let Lovestruck Beast resolve and not use the Wizard Retort on it. So, I don't know. I think that maybe I could have played that game a little bit better, but I guess I'm still learning this deck. I wasn't really ex necessarily expecting it to turn out that way. I think if we played that match again, I'd probably do better with it. But given that's the first time I've seen like what cards that deck is playing, I mean, it's cool. Like. It's like a mid-rangey kind of sort of graveyard-based Shadow Spear deck, but it also has like that sort of infect vibe to it where they're just playing a bunch of protection spells and pump stuff on their creatures so to get just push through a bajillion damage. I like it. I think it's fine. We can beat that deck for sure. I'm not worried about it. I'd love to be in the play. Yeah, I guess we're gonna keep this. It's a little bit weird. let's just hope that we can draw some creatures to play with this thing. So I don't want to have to rely on Gadwick for this. Okay, well, we might be up against the mirror here, unfortunately. No, that's legendary, so we can't actually do that. Okay, this looks like this is control. Or it could be the Phoenix deck, actually. So they liked whatever card is on top, so this looks like Phoenix. Yeah, that sucks. I need to try to get this thing online. If he has Lightning Strike, that sucks, but I don't want him to be able to do something else about it. I need to try to get this thing equipped onto it and attack as soon as possible. Because next turn we can play Island and then equip and still have Wizard's Retort up to protect it. There won't be very much you can do about it. Well, that's not good. If we get to untap, though, we're actually in good shape. Okay. Okay, that's very good for us if that's what's happening. Why did you shock yourself? What are you doing here? Come on. You obviously have to have something. But it can't be enough to erase this. Definitely not to erase the Tempest Yin we're going to play next turn. Draw two, discard two, sure. Chronic Flooding and Arc-like Phoenix. Okay, so are you playing that stupid fucking... that Hidden Strings Underworld Breach nonsense? That's the only reason you could possibly be playing this, if you're trying to play Underworld Breach in your deck. Alright, well... which means this retort has to be saved for that, because that's way more important. But it might be fine, because if we can play Jhin, just tap the Pyromancer and still attack for a bunch more damage. And the Elementals can't do anything about it. Sure. Targeting my face? Okay. You have four tokens. I can actually exchange this Gadwick. Okay, so well, that's not going to help their cause. Because you are not winning this race. I am. I have to do this first. Tap down an elemental so they cannot, like, quadruple block and kill Gadwick. And I need to, I think I need to just keep up Wizard's Retort here. Because I can just equip the Shadow Spear onto Jhin next turn, and that'll be fine. Can equip the spear to this attack, and then re-equip to Gadwick afterwards. So that way, even if they like double block it with the Phoenix, it's still fine. Sure. Or we might even draw something where we can tap down one of the Phoenixes, so that way they don't have a good block, and we'll still gain a bajillion life. But the number of tokens is definitely getting worrisome. Alright, so they have 4 cards left. How big an attack do you want to risk? Not at all. Yeah, I think they learned their lesson. Having a bunch of mana right now doesn't really matter. We just want islands. I could trade the Djinn with both of these things, but I don't really think I want to do that right now. I just want to equip the Tempest Djinn, because that deals more damage. And I don't need to really attack right now, because they can't really attack me. And if they go for, like, Lightning Strike, I still have Wizard's Retort. Or, I'm sorry, if they go for Lightning Axe. Yeah, Lightning Axe is not going to be effective right now. All I need to do is just find a blue spell I can play to tap this down. Find, like, another Gadwick, that would actually be insane. Yeah. The thing is, Tempest Djinn is our only way to push through damage at the moment. If we can get Thassa, that would also be very good. Because then we can just kill them. We can just make both of these unblockable and they die. So there is Hidden Strings here, so they do have this combo in their deck. But again, like, you can't really attack because of the Shadow Spear. This makes my Master of Waves the big Master of Waves. All right. We're going to tap a Phoenix down. So let's attack with the Tempest Djinn. Yeah, we don't need to worry about the 2 mana. Yep. Yeah, just take 2 damage. I don't think that really helps them. So here we can re-equip the spear. The question is, where do we want to put it? I think that they can't really target Master of Waves with anything, so let's equip it back onto Gadwick. Tempest Djinn is still safe because it only took 3 damage, so. But I don't think our opponent like has any way to like come back here. I don't even know if that actually matters, to be honest. I could counter this, but if they play Underworld Breach, then we actually die, so I think I just have to let Tempest Djinn die. Besides, Master of Waves is going to be a threat to kill them in 2 turns anyway, so not concerned. There's nothing they can do to stop this from happening. I don't want to give them the chance to combo, because clearly that's what they're trying to do here. We are in no danger of dying right now as long as we have the counterspell up. They only have, like, Izzet Charm, so. I guess if they have, but even if they have, like, Breach and Izzet Charm, like, it doesn't do anything because they need the mana in order to cast Hidden Strings, too. Okay, so you get your token. Sure, you deal 2 damage to Gadwick. Wild Slash. So can I, like, I don't think that matters. Again, like, Master Waves is still threatening to kill you, so I'm just gonna let Master Waves do the job. Think I have any. You don't have a. Yeah, so you don't control a creature with. I can safely block here because there's nothing you can do. You can just eat one of these things. That's beautiful. Alright. So I think we're okay here, because they only have, like, one Izzet Charm left, and if they go for Breach, then we just counter it, and then they die. Okay. What happens if they have 2 Breaches? They can just cast this from their graveyard if they have 2. No, but it's fine, because if they cast Breach, then there's nothing, they just lose. Milling 3 cards does not matter here. Show us more of your deck. So you have 1 card left in your hand. If it's Breach, it doesn't matter, right? If I just counter this thing, you only have 1 card left. So, like, what is it going to be? I think I just counter whatever your last card is. You can't mill enough cards in order for it to matter. That's it. You're dead. Alright, well, see? I knew it. So they combined Arclight Phoenix along with this Underworld Breach combo. So that's actually really scary. Alright, so I think we probably want Damping Sphere for this just because it turns off their combo. Master Waves is very good. Let's see. Tempest Djinn is also very good. We need the... I think, yeah, having the counter spells helps. What do we not need? This might be a matchup where maybe, like, Caliph and Thassa are not as good. Because I also may want these Mystical Disputes. Or Ashiok. Well, so, okay, they could have Brazen Borrower. That's possible. They're probably going to bring in Mystical Disputes of their own. Yeah. So I guess Thassa comes out and... maybe, like, 1 Gadwick, because we don't really want to tap out big against them. I think if we can just stick some flyers and put Shadow Spear on them, that's fine. I don't know, it's hard, it's difficult, but I think this is probably okay. I don't know if I don't really want to cut Trickster, because Trickster actually, It's sort of important for the devotion. Wait, I don't like cutting our two drop. So the question is Tidebinder, or actually maybe Cerulean Drake is going to be better than Merfolk Trickster because they seemed like all their creatures were red. And all their removal is red, so Drake can actually carry the spear in for victory a little bit better. So is there anything else? I could bring this back in. Yeah, it's good with him. All right, we'll try it like this. So we brought in counter spells and we brought in Damping Sphere. And I think Drake is going to be fine. They played all like red creatures, so. This hand is not particularly good. It has counter spells, but we're also going to die to like Young Pyromancer very easily, I think. This is much better. We'll keep this. I think I just put an island in the bottom. Because the chances are we're going to draw another land eventually anyway. Beautiful. We can play Damping Sphere to like turn off their ability to chain spells. They might go Pyromancer here. Oh, that's even better because now we can safely resolve this. And Master Waves is also very good. It helps us curve out more. Hope they don't have like a Braid or Borrower for this thing. But you know, it's fine. We're just going to try to put a very fast clock in them and hope that this is enough disruption to keep us from dying. Yeah, you go for this first. Yeah, they can't cast any more spells because of that too. That's nice. Attack. Let's get our devotion out so that way it'll make our Master of Waves the big Master of Waves. They might have just okay, opt, sure. Just trying to load up the graveyard for Breach. I think if I draw a Wizard's Retort, I won't play Master of Waves. Maybe. I don't know. I might want to just sit and protect this thing. Because then we would be in a winning position on board. So it might be worth sitting back. Lava Coil. Okay. So that's the only spell I can cast this turn. So they milled one Breach. So you have another one in hand. Oh, they didn't have another land, though. That's good. I think here I am gonna probably just play Storm Tamer and Singer because I want to get more devotion for this out. Yep. Okay. Yep. That's not really relevant. Just get our devotion online. Let's attack. So here we have the choice. We can make four tokens. That's probably enough to race them, I think. But I want to get this online quickly because we're running out of. Oh, okay, so they have Mystical Dispute. Fine. No. All right. It's fine. That means Gadwick can resolve and draw us a card. But they can't really win while this is on the board, so they have to find something first. Let's see. They milled two more Pyromancers, so they don't have a whole lot of win conditions left. Like, they have, what, three Breaches and one more Pyromancer? Okay. We still have flying damage in the air, which is nice. This means they're on a four-turn clock, and it might be less than that. Especially if we draw, like, another Master of Waves. But at this point, if I draw, like, Wizard Retort, I'm almost certainly holding it up. Dude, this is not racing me. Yeah, I'm absolutely doing that. So now it's a three-turn clock. Oh, alright, well, never mind then. It cannot be countered, so. Fry is a good one, that's fine. Alright, so we really want to draw another land, because I think I want to play Gadwick and be able to equip this in the same turn. So they milled their fourth Pyromancer, right? So that's one, two, or no, that's that. Never mind. That's only the third one. They milled a second Breach, though. That's worth noting. Okay. Phoenix. Alright. Phoenix is a thing. It's not bad. I think we just play Gadwick here and then draw two cards. That's great. Okay, so as long as they don't win this turn, I think we have a very good chance of racing this. Alright. How are you going to do this? I F6 through your turn. Oh, are they that desperate they just needed to do that so like they could actually try to race me? Okay, well, I'm not blocking this. Okay, that's fine. That means they wasted is that the third Breach? So I just equip this thing and then I can protect it and, like, there's no way they can beat me now. No attacks, just pass. So they have to have, like, another fry for this thing. No, we don't want to do this. Yeah, okay. Thank you. equip it there so I can block a token, but otherwise, like, this game is over. Lava Coil, I only have two cards left. I guess I could have sacked a Storm Tamer. I probably should have done that. Because this. With just four mana, though, I still don't think there's any way they can breach for the win. Yeah, like, they're still screwed anyway. But technically, the right thing to do would be sack this, because then. I guess, yeah, we want to do that just in case they do have, like, a borrower and a breach or something, but there we go. We beat the stupid breach deck. Shadow Spear did a lot of really solid work in that match. So, yeah, we saw just how ridiculously good it is giving our creatures plus one lifelink and trample. Just Phoenix did not even do anything. All right. On the play. Let's see. So this hand, like, is really weird because we can't actually, like, really cast anything. We can cast, like, Petty Theft, and that's it. There's nothing else we can do with this. I think we have to mulligan that. This is much better. We just put an island in the bottom, and this is way, way better. We're up against Big Papa Bolas, and I love it. I dig the avatar and everything. I kept seven cards. Yeah. We're just gonna keep this. So Caliph looks like it's gonna be okay. So we're up against probably blue-white control. Okay. Which means they might have like verdicts. Okay. So let's try to get at least like one strong attack in. Oh, that's beautiful. Alright, so let's attack first. I was thinking about playing Caliph this turn, but I think instead I'm just going to play Thassa. Hopefully they can't do anything about this. He could have like Quench or something. Censor. Okay, that's fine. It's a very good card to censor, for sure. Now we risk walking into verdict range. Alright, so do you have a third land? Or are you just debating which one you want to play? He does not have a third land. Beautiful. That's also beautiful. Attack. I think, yeah, I want. Let's just make them have to have something because this threatens them very fast. We'll save the Brazen Borrower in case of some. I don't know. The fact that we can flash this in and it has flying is fine. Drawing a card is not going to help you because now we have six power in play. And we can make it eight very easily. Plus, it's gonna. Yeah, you have to pay extra mana to target us. Okay, well, that actually can't do anything right now. Oh no, it's just spells. Never mind. That's not a big deal, though. We can kill off Teferi here. So I think what I'll do is I'll attack Teferi. I'm gonna wait to see if they have a fourth land. If not, I might just flash in Brazen Borrower. Yeah, because I don't want them to be able to verdict me this turn. I'll just cast Borrower. Make use of our flash speed. Counter it, like, that's fine. Yeah, it's not great, but whatever. They can't do anything this turn, but if they have Verdict, we can force them to use it by playing Caliph. Alright, so now you kind of have to Verdict this away, I think. And we can then just put in, like, Trickster, or, you know, we can also just play Master of Waves, that's fine. We don't need to get a bunch of Devotion in this match, because they don't have a lot of they don't, like, have any, like, any creatures. They don't have anything? That's gotta be good for us. All right, attack. I'm fine with punching him for six. They try to flash in a creature. Ooh, all right, that's rough. Okay, so settle the wreckage. That's kind of brutal. So I guess at the end of turn, we'll just flash in like Trickster. Actually, that might have also been a good spot to play Master. We're not in a good spot here, though, because we keep drawing lands, and we need stuff that's not land in order to combat this. Yeah, I'm going to hold back the Singer for right now. Okay, that's good. If they have a Verdict, I want them to use it before I play the Tempest Djinn. They might have another counterspell. Oh, that's not good. 5 mana, that's bad. Dig Through Time. Okay, actually, that's not good, because they're almost certainly going to find Verdict now, so... Then I guess. Yeah. We don't have a counter for it, so. Game 1 against Control is going to be a little bit tough, especially if you don't have Gadwick. Here it comes. This is 100% Supreme Verdict, yep. So I guess here we're just going to play Tempest Djinn. Wizard's Retort? No, that's not bad either, actually. So you know what? I think here I'm willing to play Master and Singer because I want to force them to use another Verdict like right away. So we just put 7 power in play, so they have to take that seriously. So this might be Verdict number 2. Yeah, okay. But now we can put in Djinn. So do I play Djinn here, or do I play Master of Waves? I guess I'm going to play the Tempest Djinn. And you know what? So here's the thing, like, what are the odds that they have a third Supreme Verdict in their hand? I could overcommit to this. Like, if I play Master of Waves, they actually will die next turn if they don't do something. But I feel like the odds they have a single removal spell are actually pretty high, so you know what? Fuck it. I'm just going to put my foot on the gas and hope for the best. So we have Lethal in play, so they have to do something, so let's hope they don't have Verdict number 3. If they do, so be it. Like, that's fine. Alright, Teferi is not a big deal, because now if they bounce like Master or something, we can still, like, punch them in the face. That's fine. Detention Sphere, okay. You know what? That's actually still not very bad, though, because we can bounce that at an opportune moment with Brazen Borrower if we draw one. There we go. Storm Tamer is good. That's some soft protection for this thing. So no targeted removal is going to take it out. And we can attack their face and just hope to kill them like that. So we're attacking for 8 and then 8. But we need them not to find the third verdict. Because if they find it, we die. Oh no, that's. Okay, you know, that's actually really bad, because now the Tempestion's going away. But if they kill Tempestion, we'd get to kill Elspeth, so. Alright. That's. I mean, it's not something I'm happy about, but it's an exchange that's probably worth it. Yeah, okay, well. All right. This is a card they usually only have like one, maybe two of in the deck, so. Sensor, cycle. Yeah, that's fine. We may need to punch this in the face. I might send the Storm Tamer after it. No. Okay, Jace. Jace is fine. So we have choices here. I could actually attack him and then kill him potentially in 2 turns. I have some soft protection, but again, the thing is, like, if he has Azorius Charm, I'd have to go after this first. Because if he Azorius Charms this, I can sack it, but it doesn't really help. I think I have to kill the Teferi first. Because that will threaten to bounce the Jhin, and I can't have him doing that. Yeah, I have to see, this is why I have to counter this thing. Teferi has to go away so that way I can like play counter spells at some point if I draw them. And so that he also just can't bounce the Jhin. I guess like that, and I'll probably take these two. Which is again still not bad because again, if he like does this Brazen Borrower, it can threaten to just bounce this and we have like a huge attack. Like, making 1/1s on the ground is not really a problem for us, so. But we need to draw something quickly. We only have a few turns left to, like, do something before this gets out of hand. Gadwick for 1,000,000 would be nice. Alright, well, now we're dying. We are flooding out. Control deck is stabilized here. They had just enough stuff. I guess, yeah, search goes by itself. This just draws a card. And, like, they can either draw 2 cards or get Azcanta. Like, they're probably taking Azcanta, yeah. For sure. That card's way better. And they did, yeah, they found verdict number 3. Like, it didn't matter because it was basically just a removal spell at that point, but. Alright, fuck it. We're just gonna draw 6 cards. We put set. Yeah, no, the sensor went in the graveyard, so we don't know about that. Alright, if they have like a, if they counter this, yeah, that's fine. Torrential Gearhulk is enough. We can't beat it. The control deck just got like too much stuff too quickly. Well, we have some tools to help us. We're going to bring in the erasures. We're going to bring in the disputes. We're going to bring in the spyglass. I think Master Waves is not really what we want in this matchup. Thassa is actually fine. Caliph is actually really good too. Singer is not particularly necessary. Actually, Shadow Spear is not really that necessary either. It can increase our clock a little bit, but I think we'd rather just keep in threats. That's actually hard though, because the Shadow Spear represents like power that goes on board all the time. No, I think we need to cut the spears against control like this. They're not pressuring our life total, so I don't think we need it. And I want to keep as many flash cards as I can. If I have to cut one thing, geez, what do I cut? I guess I could cut one Singer because this card's not terribly useful. All right, I could also cut the Trickster, but this thing also has more power. The Jace Architect of Thought can turn this off a little bit easier, so I'm gonna run it like this. Oh, we're trying to run as much flash stuff as we can. And as many counter spells as we can get our hands on, too. I would love to play first. This is hot garbage. This is better. We're gonna put a Wizard's Retort on the bottom, I think. And we'll probably just play Sorcerer's Spyglass. It's like 90% gonna name Teferi. It's kind of scary they have Elspeth in this deck. All right, there's nothing they're gonna do on this turn that I care about, so just F6. All right, let's get the Spyglass out before they can counter it. This also will tell us what's going on in their hand. Yeah, we're definitely naming Teferi Time Raveler. They do have an Absorb, so that's really it, though. They don't have, like, anything. Okay, Teferi Time Raveler it is. Their hand sucks. Chances are they might not even play Teferi. They may just try to hold up 3 mana to counter stuff. Alright. So I think here we jam Tempest Djinn. So we know they played that. Pass. Probably do have to play Teferi anyway. No, they're just going to hold up a counter. That's fine. Okay. I can always flash in Singer at their end step if I want to. Yeah, that. You know what? I should have did that there. Oops. That's stupid. All right, well, guess attacking Teferi doesn't really do anything right now. No, I still want it probably dead. Because it turns off my Wizard's Retort. Yeah, I can't do anything about that, so. But here we can go after his face. That's a good draw. So he played one Teferi, so we know he still has another Teferi. He has small Teferi and big Teferi in his hand. And again, if he wastes his turn playing another Teferi, that's fine with me. I just want to get Thassa out. Because Thassa can also just kill Teferi at any given point, so. Dovin's Veto, okay. We graveyarded it. That makes sense. He's in a very behind position right now. Yep. That's useless. I don't even know if I'm going to attack it, to be honest. No, we don't want that on top. We want that in the bottom. So he's four mana. So, okay, here's the thing. I think we do actually have to kill it, though. We can't kill him this turn. We can only put him to three, so we may as well kill Teferi and hold up the Wizard Retort for the big Teferi. So you kill Teferi, you go after his face, you go after his face. And we have, I think, if you draw Supreme Verdict, yeah, I don't want to. I want to have like stuff to put into play after that. But otherwise, I'm just gonna play Wizard's Retort, and that'll win the game. That should be the game right there. Yeah, that's not gonna do it. You're foolish if you think I'm gonna play a spell. Does this do anything? Not really. I'm gonna put it on the bottom. That's fine. I mean, I'm gonna play it because there's nothing, it doesn't hurt us to do so. Yeah, if you're settle the wreckage is not gonna do anything. Okay, so you go to 11? I just counter it and kill you. All right, so we got control that time. Like, yeah, they missed a land drop and we just absolutely crushed them. So I think that was exactly how we wanted to see that work out, though. So I'm just gonna run it back. Hope for another game two and not a game of not like another game one. I think we have the tools here. Like, we definitely can beat this deck for sure. This hand is great. We're going to keep it. It's got a bunch of really powerful cards and a counterspell, so what more could you possibly ask for? Beautiful. We can even get our Storm Tamer out so that way when we go to play these dummies, then we can protect them. And then next turn, we even have Mystical Dispute up if they play Teferi. Just tons of, awesome cards to play. Opt? No, cycle. Okay, that's fine. Means if they're cycling it, they probably need more lands. Okay, you're not gonna do anything, I'm not gonna do anything. Beautiful. We have two counter spells up now. I have no new reason to tap out now. I have two counter spells up, and that's all I need. I can just flash in Brazen Borrower at the end of turn if I so choose. Yeah, let's make him play something. I'm sure you have a counter. No, they don't even counter it. That's great. Now we are super in the driver's seat. I'm just gonna attack with this. No, I guess I could attack with both of them, right? If they have Settle the Wreckage, I can actually counter it still. I'm just gonna counter it like this. Already, I guess the reason not to do that is we don't have Wizard Retort up now. We still have Mystical Dispute, though. So if they play like a Jace or something, we can still counter it. Let's try to counter this. They might have a dispute of their own, but it looks like nope. Okay, that's good. So we still have Retort. Okay, this is getting better and better. I think that's worth countering here. I want to get more counter spells out of their hand. Okay. They can take my Brazen Borrower. I only have two cards left, though, so. If we draw a land, we can actually play Gadwick and still have a counter spell up, so. That's beautiful. So actually, no, we can't. All right. And the reason we can't is because we need blue mana for this. So I guess here, if he plays Elspeth, no, we just pl I think we just play Gadwick and draw two cards. That's fine. Fuck it. We'll just get him on card advantage. So now we can actually double spell next turn. So now next turn we can play like Caliph and Wizard's Retort. They had nothing to do. Okay, well, I'm cool with that, I guess. They can make a 1/1 token if they want. And just block. Not even gonna do that. That's interesting. Alright. Let's test the waters here. Sure. Whatever. I have to tap something. I'm trying to bait out a verdict so I can play this Tempest Shin. It looks like they just. I don't know. What do they have in hands? Like, just. It can't be like sensors or anything. Like, there's no draw spells. They didn't even make a token with this, so I don't know why. They should have at least on the end step did it. So what are you doing here? Okay, so verdict, that's fine. I expected that you had that. You can't counter this, like, well, I don't think you can. Probably not, and that, I mean, it's a two-turn clock, so. I think, yeah, we have to counter this and just try to win with it. He's down to one card. I think this is worth the risk. It's a two-turn clock, so as long as he bricks for, like, two turns. Actually, I don't want to F6. I want him to think I have Mystical Dispute. If he has Elspeth as his last card, that's gonna suck. Okay. That can't be good, though. That has to be a sign of weakness. Oh, that's beautiful. Opponent just seems to be screwed. So now, even if he gets rid of Tempest Djinn, we can just bounce the Detention Sphere on his end step. He only has one card in hand. We can bounce the Detention Sphere, get our Borrower back, and then also flash in this Borrower and still have lethal even if he removes this thing. So I think we might get there. Like, even Elspeth is not actually enough right now. Okay, that's fine. Let's go for this. So he has two cards left, so what are they? Well, in case it's Settle the Wreckage, I'm playing the Storm Tamer now. Because this will counter the Settle the Wreckage. I think they only play one, maybe two, though. If it's Absorb, you can counter that. Okay, gaining four life, sure. That is an act of desperation. But the Storm Tamer also will counter the Detention Sphere as well. That's all he has left in hand. All right. So you have to top deck something amazing right now, because Detention Sphere is not going to do it. Okay, we got there. We beat Control. See, this is what I'm telling you. We can beat Control, all right? Game one is going to be a little bit rough, but, like, we have all the tools necessary in order to defeat this deck. We have tons of ridiculously good threats. They're, like, 3 mana or less, you know. Being able to flash things in and have counter spells up all the time, just very, very good. So Control is a deck, like, it is going to be a hard match. Like, you have to play very carefully, and so things have to, like, not go super terribly for you, but I think in general we have a pretty good edge against their deck. Just, again, the counter spells and the, like, Gadwick is amazing. Gadwick just filling up our, yeah, he drew us 2 cards there. Helped us, you know, break through the flood. That was nice. And we were able to stick Tempest in here. We even got to make use of Borrower and Siren Storm Tamer. Like, all of these cards working together in synergy, doing what they're supposed to do. Alright, we are on the draw. This hand is fine. We keep this. It's got a very good curve to it. Can disrupt anything that our opponent's going to play. Breeding Pool, okay. I don't know, what do we play against that, like, plays Breeding Pool? Okay, this is some, this is Dredgeless, okay, that makes sense. So we're probably gonna play Trickster and then just flash in Borrower. Alright, yeah, they have this stupid Titan card, that's scary. I almost don't even want to kill the Satyr Wayfinder because this stupid Titan is very scary. Okay. Alright, well, now it doesn't matter because they can definitely cast it next turn. Right? Now, they don't have a second blue yet, so that's worth noting. Scarab God? That's not what I want to be seeing. Okay, well, they're not familiar with this trick yet. We could be seeing a 6-6 next turn. So I think here we want to play Tempest in. It's just going to be the fastest clock. Can race the Titan. The only good news is I don't think this deck plays very much removal, because I think it's just all a bunch of, like, graveyard filling up stuff. Okay, so they are going to play the Titan this turn. No? Okay, Wilderness Reclamation. What's that all about? What do you have that you're doing at instant speed in my turn? Oh, are you going to play fucking Nexus of Fate? Like, isn't that card banned in this format? No. Okay. I guess just attack first, right? I could just play Master of Waves first, just in case that they, like, have some kind of combat trick. I mean, it just feels like the mana efficient thing to do, because then next turn I can Borrower and Tempest in, and then the turn after that, Master Waves again. I don't really want to play Thassa here. I think, alright, let's do Master first. I'm really interested to know why they're playing Wilderness Reclamation. Maybe they... Okay. I'm just checking. Is Nexus legal? I thought Nexus was not, but maybe it is. So maybe that this could be a Nexus deck. No, it is banned in Pioneer. Okay, so yeah, I'm totally lost as to what they're doing with all of this. I don't have any way to give their stuff flash, so, or at least not as far as I know. Maple Passage, okay. This guy could be coming back at any other time. Do they have some kind of reanimation? Oh, they have Scarab God. Okay, that's terrible. So I think we probably have to bounce Scarab God. Because I do not want him... I don't want him blocking with that thing. We might be able to just tempo it out anyway. Okay, so what do you got here? Like, oh, fuck. Now I see what's going on. All right. They can actually, like, loop this, I think. So here, now we actually have to make a choice because I think Tempestion is the correct thing to do. We're going to have a hard time attacking through this. Yeah, I can't bounce this because he's just going to exile something from... If I bounce it, like, he can just... like, exile the fucking other Scarab God from his graveyard and just make it, yeah, that's not really what I want to be seeing right now. Whereas Singer, I can, like, actually deploy that or Brazen Borrower this turn. Yeah, I can't really attack right now. But I might be able to play Thassa next turn. I'm hoping that... if he exiles the Uro, then I will just bounce that. Now, Satyr Wayfinder, yeah, that makes sense. It's a 4-4 zombie. Master Wave's going to have to hold the fort down for a little while. So we're going to lose 2 life. Okay, so I kind of see the combo here. Scarab God and Wilderness Reclamation. You want to just fill up your graveyard and do this every other turn. I am not really cool with this whole Frilled Mystic nonsense that you just put into the graveyard, because now it's going to make life incredibly difficult for us. And you have enough mana to... like, if you do this... now, you can just wait till your end step to do it. That's the problem. If I try to do anything now, you can just, like, exile the Mystic. Yeah. Like, I don't think we're winning this. There's way too many Mystics in the graveyard now. So, we're only going to get one chance at this. So what are you going to exile? I mean, that's gonna happen. Or you just escape that, that's fine. So I think here I have no choice. I have to bounce the Scarab God. Because if I don't bounce the Scarab God, then he's just going to be able to counter anything I do next turn. So we have to Petty Theft this right now. That gives us one turn to resolve spells. So it's probably got to be Thassa and Singer. Because now there's nothing he can really do with his mana. Yeah, you can cast that. Okay, never mind. This actually changes everything. Fuck. So Shadow Spear and this, like... I think that might actually be enough to erase this. Because next turn, if you, again, so it costs you 5 mana to play Scarab God. Alright, I have to equip this now. There's no other choice. I just have to attack in the air, because that's The only way I can, like, possibly win here. And I'm gonna have to try to use Singer in combat. Right. So he's gonna have. So he has five. If he plays a land. Yeah, if he does play a land, then he's gonna be able to do that and exile a creature. Alright. So, yep, scry two. But I think the Shadow Spirit actually just changed the combat, like, a whole bunch. Because now we actually have the possibility of getting through this. We cannot, we still can't resolve a spell. We need to have, like, a counterspell first. But actually, we need, like, two counterspells. So what has to happen now is... Okay, that's good. He's going to combat first. Okay. Let's play our Singer. I don't really want to kill this thing, though. Oh, he had the fourth one in hand, fuck. Alright. But at least this means Scarab God's probably not going to be a thing. Does this have Trample? No, it actually doesn't. I don't really want to, block it. Or if, I don't want to kill it, because then he can just escape it again. This is good. Now we have another turn to resolve spells, so we can just play, like, another Master of Waves. Or we could play Thassa. Thassa might actually be the call, too, because we can make the Djinn unblockable. Okay, so you can get your Scarab... Oh, fuck, no, we can't. Never mind. Because he's got the Wilderness Reclamation still, so... No, we're still relying on Djinn to help get us there. Alright. The good news is that he can't really block anything this turn with that, so... oh, okay, so Singer, yeah, that's a thing, I guess. Yeah, you can chump block with it. It's only a 4-4, though, so... Alright, let's just see if we can sneak this through without him doing anything. The correct thing to do would just be to put Frilled Mystic in play, but, like, we are very quickly, like, losing the ability to race this, because now Brazen Bower plus this can actually double block here. Alright, I think now we've actually lost because of the Singer dying. Alright, I'll concede. We cannot resolve a spell anymore, so, and he's got too much power, we're not going to catch up to it. It's fine. So, Jesus Christ, this is a deck. I think this might actually be, well, he's got Brazen Borrower, so Ashiok's Erasure doesn't really do much. The counter spells are kind of good, though. Tidebinder seems like it's fine. I don't know. We really do not want to let Scarab God resolve, so... Actually, I think maybe Mystical Dispute is the thing, because it counters Scarab God and, like... Most of the really good spells in their deck are blue. I think that's probably fine. They've got a lot of big, scary things. I don't know if Caliph is going to do it. I think this is definitely going to be a Shadow Spear match. What do we take out for this? Thassa seems great. Like, all of these cards actually seem like they're very good. What about Master of Waves? they can't really remove our board, so if we can just, if we can resolve our stuff, I think that's actually good. Yeah, we just cannot, we absolutely cannot let Scarab God resolve. That's the huge problem. This only protects a creature, so, I mean, we could exile Scarab God with this, like, but I guess the issue with that is, yeah, they still have Brazen Borrowers in their deck, so they could very easily just bounce it. Same thing with, like, Spyglass. It's not going to do anything against their deck. Caliph, I don't know if it's going to get through enough. It's hard. There's definitely an argument that Tidebinder is going to be better than some of these guys. Because Tidebinder can also tap down the Titan. Alright, I'm going to bring in Tidebinder. I'll take out this Singer. Think that this is probably just a little bit better. It also turns on the Retort faster. What about Gadwick? Like, he taps stuff down pretty well, drawing cards, like... I'm not sure what to do here. We need to cut some stuff. Alright. I don't know what to do, so I'm going to cut one... Alright, I'm going to cut Caliph. Submit. I don't know if that's right, but that's what I'm going to do. I think the rest of these cards are all fine. This is definitely a match where we would rather have some graveyard hate. This hand's really good. We'll keep. Again, we have a strong curve here. Maybe the Storm Tamer's not that necessary. I guess maybe I could have cut that. I don't know. Like, they haven't shown us any actual removal, though, so maybe they probably don't have, like, anything. But it just turns on Wizard's Retort, and, like, it keeps our Wizard density high. I think we're just going to flash in Trickster in their end step. Actually, are we going to do... Yeah, I think we are. Because I want to play... I want to save Tidebinder longer if I can. If they play the Satyr, that's fine. Because I can just tap it down now. Attack for 3, put the Djinn in play. They do have Fatal Push. Okay, so that's worth noting. Okay. So what do I do here? If I play the Tempest Djinn, it is vulnerable. I could play the Tidebinder Mage, actually, and then next turn play Tempest Djinn. I like this plan. Because now, so yeah, the Storm Tamer is helping, because now, like, we know that they have removal, so. And we're threatening to attack for, like, 5 this turn. It's not insignificant. So they want to cast like a black spell, they have to shock themselves. Okay, good, excellent. Oh, beautiful. This is all coming together. So they are on a much slower roll this game. I mean, you can petty theft something. Okay. Why the Trickster? That doesn't make sense. Well, let's just put the biggest clock on the board, I guess. Because now, if at any point they threaten to play Borrower, we can just flash in Trickster and tap it, and we get our damage in still. Like, they can't Assassin's Trophy this thing. Oh! Well, I guess that makes sense. They brought in Languish? That's Shocking, actually. All right, well, let's just play Gadwick and draw a card. Master, all right, so chances are we're going to play Master Waves next turn. Just it'll be the most mana efficient thing to do. They're not going to be able to block Gadwick, more than likely. Well, that sucks. They don't have anything in the grave. Oh, fuck, no. They can get Tempestion back. Okay, so I think here, I think we have to bounce this thing. Can we tempo through this? I don't know. I cannot let him just untap with that. If he's gonna replay it, I want him to take his entire turn to do it. Okay. The goose is loose. Let's do this. Tap down the goose. We'll get Master Waves online, make a bunch of tokens, and hopefully we can just push past this for the win. Okay, let's hope that this is good enough. Like, now, even if they get, like, Jhin back, it's not going to be enough. So we can just, like, Trickster and tap stuff down, or just even cast another Master of Waves. They're only at 5, and we have enough. They have to kill at least 2 things. Alright, so. Got there in game 2. Alright, so Master of Waves looked like it was actually not bad. I think that this was fine. I don't know if I want to really change anything. Like, it's really scary to have this in the graveyard, but I don't know what else we can do. Like, we have to just keep this stuff like this. And now that we know they have removal, the Storm Tamer just has to stay. So the only thing I might consider is maybe the Singer could come out for something. Not really anything here I want to do. Yeah, I think we just have to do it like this. We didn't see a counterspell that time, so, like, Scarab Guide was still scary. I think if we can keep that from reanimating things, we have a pretty good shot. I guess, this is really tough. We're on the draw. We have two lands into, like, Master and the Gadwick. I don't actually know if this is going to beat this deck, because we're not guaranteed to be able to cast it like any of these, and these are not enough. I think I'd rather mulligan for something a little bit better. I think this is better. Think we're gonna keep this, and I think Thassa is gonna go on the bottom because I want to be able to have. Does she though? There's also the reasonable possibility Shadow Spear goes in the bottom, actually. And we just go the devotion route and hope that Thassa can get there. You know what? I'm gonna put Shadow Spear on the bottom. I think this hand is a little bit better because now we can be sure that we're gonna cast our spells, and we have instead of needing to top deck like another land, or you know, try to find counter spells, we can just use Thassa to dig for counters. Even better. But now that we also know about Languish, we can also be a little bit more Yeah, we can be more careful too. We didn't have a satyr, that's a good sign. When it enters the battlefield, you can gain 3 life and draw, so it's gonna explore him. I mean, I guess that's gonna be fine. I'm gonna wait 1 turn for this. So he does have another land, all right. Okay. As soon as we get priority, we'll just tap this down and pass. So they're out of actions for this turn. So I think here I do actually have to hold up the dispute. Because if he plays Scarab God, I need to counter it. And that's why I was like, I didn't counter the Titan because we need this for the Scarab God. That's just absolutely necessary. And he has all 5 mana now. Even if he doesn't have another land, somehow we can just crack the food for it. So we are just hoping that he's going to go for Scarab God and we can dispute it right now. Okay. But next turn, then, we can also play Thassa and still hold this up. So, do you not have anything, or are you just, like, scared? Okay. No, I'm not. I'm not going to counter that because, again, I need to save the dispute for the god. Okay, it's fine. He only has 2 cards left in hand, so. And 1 card left. Alright, excellent. So if it is Scarab God and that's what he's banking on, well, you know what? Now he has enough mana to just pay for it anyway, so now we're fucked. Too many lands. So now our dispute's not even worth anything. That was maybe the, yeah, I should have paid attention to that because then that might have actually made sense there. Okay, well, never mind. Meat's back on the menu, boys. Double dispute means now we can punch through Scarab God. Yep. I mean, Vantress is going to do its thing. We'll probably have to flash in this Trickster at his end step and just hope that we don't have to deal with Languish. Yeah, you make a food. All right, is this happening? Yeah, I guess. Again. He's casting the one from hand. So if he casts the one from the graveyard, I do have to dispute it, I think. Okay. Interesting. He's not going to go for it. Well, he committed another goose, so I feel better about committing another trickster. We are in trouble, to be honest. Like, he's drawing a lot more value cards than we are, so we need something like Gadwick quickly. Okay, that screams like, that absolutely screams that he's gonna wipe the board. If he's throwing away the goose, it's because he's just gonna languish everything. And I don't think I can counter it. If he's gonna do it, though, I would expect him. Ooh, okay. Well, we have to do it like this. So I'll pay 3, and then we can just do it again. Can't let him do that because it draws a card every time it attacks. Alright, well now we're just in shit creek. He's got 3 cards, we've got nothing, we're flooding out. We've drawn 7 lands and 6 not lands. I think maybe if we had, like, protected Thassa, that might have been worth it. But now we're probably just screwed. Yeah, okay. I mean, I knew that was going to happen, because that's why he blocked with the goose. And of course he has another Titan, so... It just replaces itself and just makes it easier for him to recast it, too. Just going to make food every turn. Alright, well, that's exactly what we needed to have a chance in this game. So, draw 4 cards it is, I guess! That's the only way that we can possibly, like, come back here. And those are some really good draws off of this, too. We can, like, just absolutely slam the board full of stuff now. Okay, so... If he's going to languish again, I'm okay with that. Okay, you make a food token. It's worth noting because he has food tokens, fatal pushes are all live. I'm going to play Master of Waves. I don't know. I guess tap a food token. We have to tap something. Okay, well, Gadwick off the top is keeping us alive. So, Scry 2, so we might be looking for another Languish. Or even Fatal Push is not bad here. If he gets rid of the Master of Waves, then I will just play the Tempestion. And if he languishes, I'm just going to drop Gadwick for 1,000,000. Upkeep, are you going to do this? No, you already drew. Never mind. Okay, so languish, that's fine. So he has Titan available now. What the fuck? You don't need that much mana, unless you're Scarab Godding. That's bad. Okay, I don't understand that. Why did you need to shock yourself? Oh, you have a goose in hand. Alright, that's fine. Okay, we can still potentially, like, get out of this, because we just have to drop Gadwick and draw a bajillion cards again. So, let's just draw 6 cards. Okay, well, there we go. That might be enough to, like, outvalue our opponent. We just drew 6 cards off of Gadwick, so... He's gonna draw a card every turn. He's gotta do a lot of work to catch up here. Now we also have counter spells available, too. Okay, so how do we, like, go about doing this? Thassa... So we need to keep up 2 mana for Wizard's Retort, so, what do we do? I don't want to get too greedy here, but I also, like, I don't think I need to play Shadow Spear this turn. I want to do it next turn. So I guess we can attack first, because I don't think he's going to block. And we're definitely not blocking. So the question is, we can play Thassa, and then we'll have, they said, 4 mana left, so we could play this and have 3 left, and then we can play Tempest Shin. So it's 2 Languishes and Exile already, so chance, like, there's no way he's gonna have 3 of them. So I think the, yeah, Thassa plus Storm Tamer keeps both things alive. And yeah, Jhin's just like gonna kill him, and then next turn we can just play Shadow Spear and like crush him. So let's play Thassa first. Alright. Yeah, I guess we have to just tap stuff. The other option is we could wake Thassa up in combat too, or we can just like tap Merfolk Trickster and keep this thing from attacking in this turn. That's worth it, possibly. So I could go Storm Tamer here and then Trickster. I like that plan, actually. Don't know. I'm gonna tap this again. Because I also want to keep up at least 2 wizards in case they in case they manage to remove one of these things. So I can still use Storm Tamer and the Wizard's Retort if I want. Because Trickster will leave me with 3 mana. Okay, gaining 3 life is not going to help you. So Gadwick is trying his absolute damnedest to keep us in this game. Yeah, go ahead and gain all the life you want. We are going to absolutely destroy you. Brazen Borrower at plus Gadwick is going to be great. All right, so Trickster, we tap down this. Okay, and then we tap down the Gilded Goose. So now we've got like a bajillion power in play. We have 2 Wizard's Retorts in hand. We can protect Gadwick with Storm Tamer, and that'll be fine. End step, yeah, they're not doing anything. Okay, Scry, what do we got? Master of Waves, I mean, we can. There's absolutely nothing stopping us from doing that. Is there anything else I would rather have right now? I mean, I guess this card is fine, because if we need to rebuild, then we have the option to do so with that. So I guess Shadow Spear, we're going to play and equip it to Thassa. And then Brazen Borrower, we can just like bounce Gilded Goose back to their hand in their turn and then do this again. You gonna scry too, or what's your plan? No, thank you. I would like to not do that. I really want to hit you in the face. Sure. I'm gonna crack another food. Scry too. That's fine. So we still have Wizard's Retort online. This point, I think, yeah, I'm just gonna bounce the Gilded Goose back to your hand so that way I can get a tap trigger off of this, keep this from attacking again. to find it. No fucking way. That ain't happening. Alright, sure. You got yourself a scarab god. Is that gonna matter though? Like, I think I'm still gonna kill you, and I don't think there's much you can really do about it. Because this turn I'm definitely just playing Master of Waves. I think there's no reason not to do that. Doesn't matter, like, are you dead on board though? Like, that's 8, 11, 8, 9, 10, 12. I can't quite kill you, and you have a food token, so be over the course of 2 turns. I can play Master of Waves, make Thassa unblockable. Actually, I don't even need to. I can just play Master of Waves and tap Scarab God. Come on, Wizard's Retort. Or honestly, there's a lot of cards that we could draw right now that would be fine. I guess this makes sense to do this now. Merfolk Trickster, huh? Okay, that makes sense. Yeah. You can target Thassa if you want. It is going to target Thassa, so... Again, does that really matter? I can just play 2 creatures and just tap this down. Scry's already on the stack. Do I care if Thassa is tapped here? I can also sack the Siren Storm Tamer to this and just, like, ignore it entirely. I don't know if I don't think that that's necessary though. I think I'd rather protect you save the Storm Tamer to protect something from Fatal Push. Alright, I'm gonna say the question is, do I want to make anything unblockable? I don't know if I'm gonna have enough mana to do that. I think I'm just going to cast 2 spells, and then if I draw a land, then I can just re-equip Shadow Spear, so yeah. That's fine. Thassa's tap down. Oh. Okay, well, yeah, we do want that on top. Okay. Oh yeah, this needs to resolve first. So, I can attack for a lot here. So, I believe what I do is I re-equip Shadow Spear. Equip, we'll put it on, I guess, Skadwick. It does the most, it gains me the most life. And I still have Brazen Borrower that I can flash in, so... Brazen Borrower can just, like, tap down the Uro, and it's fine. They can do the thing with the Trickster, like, one more time, or... I can actually just, like, not play the Borrower. I can just take... It doesn't matter at this point. Like, I have enough to just, like, kill them with going wide. Like, I don't think there's anything they can... Like, Nothing short of Languish is going to do it here. I think at this point I just let them attack me, right? They're only attacking for 15, and they die if they do that. They put one card in the bottom, so that's not a good sign for them. Shrivel, huh? Alright, well, that sucks. But we still, I think, are going to kill them. Like, I don't think that was enough. Okay. Let's tap down the Scarab God, I guess. They're only at 9, so, alright. Merfolk Trickster, okay. Does it matter, though? I can just make things unblockable right now. Okay, sure, you tap down Thassa. Put on top of my deck, I think. Yes. So they can't block anything, so I guess I'm just going to attack them. This represents tapping down two things, so. Gaining 3 life is not going to help you. You are still taking way more than lethal. Alright, we got there. That was a ridiculously scary deck. Oh my god, this is dragging on forever. We're at like almost 2.5 hours, so. Doing good. That was a hell of a match, I gotta be honest. Like, trying to grind out the Scarab God is crazy. Gadwick for drawing 6 cards, oh my god, what a beast. And Shadow Spear again showing its worth too. It, like, definitely let us attack and keep the life totals from getting out of hand. So we could actually, we could tank an attack for, like, 15 and, like, not care. That was good. I liked it. So, we're doing good with this deck so far, and I think that if we were more experienced with the first match, I think we could probably win that one, but my god, this is getting late already. Alright, let's try. Hopefully this is not going to be another one of those, because that match went on freaking forever. Okay, we are on the draw. Alright. So hand's a little bit slow. I don't know if I like slow on the draw against an unknown opponent. I think I'd rather mulligan at least once. Well, this was actually worse. Alright. Jesus Christ. Okay, well, this is going on the bottom, and I guess this is going on the bottom. I feel really bad for not having kept the first hand now, but this is not good. Alright, well, it looks like we're up against blue-white control again, so. Alright, well, that's good. That means that we have a shot here, but game one is going to be very rough against them. He kept 7 cards to our 5, so, like, the odds that we're going to beat them are not very high. I'm just going to flash in Trickster, probably, in their end step. Actually, I might even flash in just Singer. Actually, you know what? I'm going to do Trickster now while they can't censor it. You can play Teferi. Yeah, this sucks. I mean, that it is what it is. That's going to happen. We are in trouble. We don't have lands. We're not going to win this. Our opponent's curving out, and we're not. Is this 4 other lands? Yeah. Or 4 or more lands. Okay. Well, that makes it really hard. Like, we're not going to kill Teferi now. Yeah. Ah, fuck. All right. I wanted the match to go quick, but I didn't want it to go quick because we were getting boned. Depending upon what our opponent does, like, we're close to the point where we might just concede. Alright, well, let's try to attack. Sure, he has a counterspell for this. Once they resolve another planeswalker, we're conceding, I think. Very likely. This is just too much. Like, they got Teferi in turn 3, and we couldn't, so. Yeah, alright. You know what? Fuck it. No. I think this game is, like, gone too far, like, into the deep end for us, so. They have too much control over the board. It's also late, and I don't feel like trying to spend the next half hour grinding out like a 0.1% of a chance to like win that match. So, I think what did we say? Master of Waves was... Is that the one that we... No, we cut Shadow Spear, right? I think we cut Master... Everything else seems like this is... Like, Caliph... I mean, this card is very good. Like, Caliph is... Do we keep this card over Master of Waves? Like, the thing is, it doesn't play very well against Verdict, so maybe... The problem is, like, it's hard to resolve Master of Waves and protect it. It puts more power on the board right away. Yeah, that's like, this is just easier to play, though, like, I don't know, like, even if we play a flash in a Trickster or something in the end step, it still attacks for 4, I guess it's fine. Oh, we need Ashiok's Erasure, alright, so yeah, Master Waves and, I don't know, maybe I'll just cut one of these. No, you know what, no, it's gotta be the Singer, like, we wanna keep, like, the power cards. Alright, we'll do it like that. I think that's what we did last time. I don't have notes for this. I don't remember, but it's what I'm doing. We just kind of got mana screwed. This hand is fine. We'll keep this. If we can stick Thassa early enough, that'll be good. Mold to 6. Okay, that's good. That means the aggro plan might work against him. Yep. I guess I'm gonna do this now just to get underneath sensor. I don't know if all of the decks are playing it, but enough of them are that I think we obviously saw them do it before, so it's worth doing, I think. Oh, that's beautiful. All right, so we can counter Teferi now. And they did have it too, so. They don't have Mystical Dispute up actually, so maybe this is a good time to get Jamthassa. Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna do that. And if they get Teferi down, so be it. Because we can play two creatures and then hopefully. They're stuck in two lands. Excellent. Punished. All right. That's fine. We can put that on top. So we can flash that in at the end of their turn. And then we'll have Thassa in play as well. Right, well, we lost a mana screw. It looks like our opponent might get screwed by it now. Absolutely fucking not. No! Alright, we'll get in Trickster so we can get an attack with Thassa in. Come on, that's fine, we'll put that on top. Okay, good. You have to, like, Verdict or you die now. And even if you verdicts, like, you're still gonna go to one. Okay. Get our two cards. All right, do something about this or you die. Okay. If we find a land, they're actually dead. I'm gonna put that on the bottom just because, again, if we find land, they die. Okay. So I guess here we can just play this thing, right? Ooh. Okay, well, I guess we're just playing. They're probably going to play Detention Sphere. That's fine. Well, yeah, if they Detention Sphere this again, we still threaten to kill them with Thassa. I guess we're just going to name Teferi Hero of Dominaria. Right, pass. This still threatens to kill them, and if they just play like Mentor, then we just make it unblockable. So they have to take this. Okay, which means I don't think that there's anything they can do if we top deck a land. Yeah, no, okay, so again, Island wins the game. Island, or actually like any two drop. So there's a lot of cards that win here. That's not one of them. All right, that wins us the game. All right, cool. All right, well, he missed a land drop and we super punished him for it. Caliph was okay. It was just like a 3-3. I guess the thing is like it's easier to play this and leave up a counterspell, so maybe that's good enough for us to do that. Yeah, I guess that's fine. All right, we're just running it back, I think. That's all right, last game of the night. This league has gone on way too long. This hand is okay. It could be a little bit better, but I'm happy enough with this. We have enough flash things to do. More flash things. probably want to jam Trickster here. You know what, let's test the waters with the Singer. I think the Trickster's worth a little bit more, so. I mean, I'm happy if they use removal on this thing. They just put it on top. Okay, that's fine. If they tap out for, like, Jace or Teferi, we just counter it. Okay. Again, like, I'm still fine with that. Those little creatures can still beat down just fine. And again, if you tap out at any point, like, we still have the retort. So we're making forward progress, I think, because now we have mana and we have creatures on the board. Yeah, that's fine. I would love to get some basics out of my deck, actually. No, I don't want to do anything here. I need to hold up Wizard's Retort. And I'm not going to walk into Censor. There's no reason to do that. Yes, take damage. You know what it feels like. Take their time. Yeah. I mean, I'm not super happy about that, but my feeling is the three cards left in their hands are, I need to be have a counterspell, because they're probably sandbagging Planeswalkers, because they think we just have counter magic up. So, I have to just unfortunately let that happen. And if they're smart, they won't play Elspeth until they can protect it. I think if they play Teferi, though, I will just flash in a bunch of creatures. No, I don't need to play this right now. That's good. See if we can draw out a counterspell with this. They let us have it. That's surprising. I don't think they should have let us have it. Unless they're setting up to, like, dig through time again. Looks like it. No, Castle Vantress. Okay, that's fine. So Supreme Verdict might be online this turn. But we're not doing bad. We got Thassa in play. That's important. She'll help us grind out card quality the same way that, like, Vantress is going to, and she threatens to also wake up and just start attacking. They already used a Settle the Wreckage, so I'm not super concerned about that. Supreme Verdict, okay. I expected that. Alright, jam a Trickster. Okay, sure. We don't want that. That is actually fine. We need something to threaten them with, though, but having, like, two counterspells up is good, though. It sucks that we have both Nykthos right now, but at any given point, like if we just draw like Gadwick, then we're, and they tap out big, then we're just gonna definitely catch up. I really don't want that to be a thing. Nope. Please no. What did I just say, deck? Come on. What part of no do you not understand? We put it on the bottom for a reason. All right, so they did have the sensor the whole time. I knew it. Yeah, and we have to, like, Mentor is a huge problem, so. Yeah, that's fine. Detention Sphere is gonna eat Thassa. There's nothing I can do about that. Because I need to keep this up in case they try to jam Teferi. Or if at any point they ever try to jam a Planeswalker. Alright, well that's gonna help our cause. They don't have anything, I can just name one of the castles. Alright. Lyra Dawnbringer absorbed. Alright, so that's worth noting. So here I think we might just name. We might actually name Castle Vantress. I don't think that Ardenvale is that big a deal. A 1/1 human is not really going to do much, especially in a verdict deck. So yeah, I think I'm just going to name Castle Vantress now. Okay, so we have enough to, if they go for Lyra, we can dispute it. I don't know, like. Alright, they doing it? Oh, but they have Mystical Dispute in their hand. Right? Fuck. I should have used the Nykthos to cast this because then I could have replayed this and still had up enough mana for this. So I guess I have to let this resolve just in case I draw Brazen Borrower. Because in that case, then I can actually bounce it and have a better shot at countering it. This is gonna kill us though. Like, not tapping the Nykthos was a mistake because that way, like, I could have played the second Nykthos and had up. I know. No, I wouldn't have even because I would only. No, because this would be. Yeah, I would only have one island tapped and I would have. This one would be untapped, so it would be. I would have 6 mana, so I would be able to counter this and still hold it up. That was a mistake. But we didn't know that was happening. That's too late. It's not going to do anything at this point. Sure. Okay, well, they still don't have, like, they still just have this stuff, so I guess. Yeah, Ardenvale. All right, well, we have a couple turns in order to try to race this thing, but not many. They can pay for it, so it doesn't actually help us. The thing is, if they bounce the Sorceress Spyglass, it doesn't actually help them. Yeah, but now we're in trouble because we need Borrower. Yeah, we're fucked. All right. Pass. Again, we're like flooding out here. I mean, the Spyglass mistake didn't really help us, but I guess that, I don't know. I should have been paying attention to how much mana I had. But now with Teferi on board, like, this almost doesn't even matter. Because I know they have Absorb, so I can play the Tempest in, it's just gonna get countered, and I can't counter it back. Alright, you got this opponent. Like, that sucks. I think that maybe I could have played that a little better, but in the end, like, I think they still were just drawing a little bit better than us, so. We had one control match go our way, and one of them did not, so it is what it is. 3-2, though. Like, not bad. We didn't really get to see Caliph do very much. I don't know if I believe in this card. This could be something better. Maybe, like, more Brazen Borrowers. Like, we could play, like, another Borrower and then, like, something else. I don't know. It could also be Cloudfin Raptors, because then it's more stuff to put the sword on. Or maybe, like, we side in, or we bring in two of, like, these Ashiok Erasures from the sideboard. We could put those in the main deck and then have, like, some room for Cage. I actually kind of like that. Or the other possibility is bring in two Tidebinder Mage from the sideboard, go up to four Drakes, and then we have our two Cages. Which, with all the escape cards, it might actually be a good idea to do that. Our three drop slot is a little bit clunky with this. It just didn't really do that much, unfortunately. I think the Singer was okay. I don't know if I like super believed in this. I think if we test it a little bit more, it'll be fine. I like that it lets us take a more controlling role in a game, so that's definitely beautiful, but the Shadow Spear, I think, really showed that like it helps a lot. Gadwick, as always, like was super great every time that we had it. So we didn't get to see Ashiok's Erasure at all, unfortunately. Like, we put it in the side because we wanted to test, but yeah, so I think this was good, this was medium, and this was just like kind of, I don't know, super medium, I guess. So I would ex but this fits on the like I think this fits on the curve a little bit better because we have like way too many threes. With Borrower, Gadwick, and Shin, I think we need more twos or ones or twos in the deck, so if anything's going, it's probably this, and it's probably going to be to bring in like Tidebinders. They're just generically like fine. They're wizards to turn on Wizard's Retort, so this is dead less often, which matters because we took out the Harbinger, so other than that, like yeah, like I said, I think the spear was good. I'm gonna probably play the next league with this card. So I have to like look and evaluate this because I think the spear was worth playing. So even I might try a list with Cloudfin and Spear just to see how that goes. I don't know. We'll see. Or like I said, maybe I'll just make the subtle change to this and we'll work from this one because I do think there is some serious like power in this card and I'm really interested in doing it. And I don't think that like. I don't know. It's not absolutely necessary to jam stuff like Cyclonic Rift into the deck. Like, it's certainly good, but when the problem is when you're playing three Nykthos, it makes it hard to play stuff like Djinn and Gadwick on curve. And it's only like Nykthos is a card that's only really good in the late game, and if you draw multiples early on, you're kind of screwed by it. So I've been leaning towards the 23 land version with just two Nykthos. I think that that's probably where I'll stick. I don't really miss the third one at all. And like we saw last game, like having the second Nykthos was a huge problem because then we couldn't counter Lyra and like have the counter spell up for the dispute. Well, it is what it is. Like I said, we went 3-2, so it wasn't like a total like clusterfuck or anything. Like those were two definitely very winnable matches, and I think with more practice in this new format with the new cards, like I think we can improve the bar. All right, let's not be using the Royal Wii for this. I can improve my play. All right, so wow, this league has gone on for all what almost 3 hours. Insane. Thanks for everybody who stuck it out with me here. I appreciate your coming here and watching. I don't really ask for much. I don't like do Patreon or anything like that. I am totally self-funded and I like it being that way. So if you want to show support, just like all the videos and just subscribe and comment. I always try to respond to the comments whenever I see them. So if you have questions or you want to say that like, oh, you're a dummy, why would you do this? Or if you just want to give me a pat on the back, you know what? Post it in the comments and you know I always read through them and I try to reply to them because I appreciate every time that everybody comes to check me out playing the stuff. So yeah, with that, I am going to bed. It's late. So good night, everybody.